Hello students, in this video we will understand the complete details about electrical resistance and conductance. Further, we will also see various types of conductivities like specific conductivity, equivalent conductivity and molar conductivities. Okay, so let's get started. What is resistance? Resistance is the restriction towards the flow of electricity. So every substance, right? It can be in terms of a solution or an electrolyte, or you can say a substance in the form of a conductor, right? They offer resistance to the flow of electricity to a small or a larger extent. And the exact value of the resistance you can find out with the help of Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? Ohm's law can be stated as R is equal to E upon I. That means if you consider a conductor, and if to the ends of a conductor we apply certain voltage, right, and a current is flowing through it, then the resistance of the conductor is given by this particular formula, right, whereby the voltage is given in terms of E and current is given in terms of I, which is measured in amperes. Okay, so same thing we can write it down as Ohms is equal to volts per amperes, because voltage is in terms of volts and current in terms of amperes, resistance in terms of ohms. Is it right? As far as conductance is concerned, what is conductance? It is the reciprocal of the electrical resistance and it is represented by capital C. So conductance is C is equal to 1 upon R, right? As far as the units of conductance are concerned, so units of conductance you can give in terms of Siemens, which is represented as capital S. You can give it in terms of reciprocal of ohm, that is ohm inverse, right? Or you can also specify it in terms of MHO. Okay, ohm inverse and MHO is one and the same thing, right? So if you consider a solution which has a resistance of 10 ohms, okay, then what would be the conductance of such solution? That conductance, you can say, it will be reciprocal of this. So it will be 1 upon 10. You can say 1 upon 10 ohm inverse. You can also write it down as 1 upon 10 MHOs. It's one and the same thing, reciprocal of ohm. Or you can write it is 1 upon 10 Siemens. Is it okay? After this, we'll next see the details about specific conductivity. It is observed that resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to its length and inversely proportional to its area of cross section. Okay, so if I want to remove this proportionality sign, I need to add certain constant of proportionality. That means, say I am writing R is equal to rho into L upon A. Now this rho, which is a constant of proportionality, is called as specific resistance or resistivity. Okay, and it depends upon the material of the conductor which you are using. Okay, so as you know, reciprocal of resistance is conductance. Similarly, reciprocal of resistivity is known as specific conductivity, which we are talking about. Okay, now the specific conductivity is given by the parameter kappa, right? That means resistivity is rho, so it is reciprocal of specific conductivity, so that becomes 1 upon kappa. Is it clear? Okay, now let us move ahead. Now we have R is equal to rho into L upon A, right? What is R? R is reciprocal of conductance, so it is 1 upon C. What you got the value for rho? Resistivity is reciprocal of specific conductivity, so that is 1 upon kappa into L upon A, right? The same equation I can write it down as K is equal to C into L upon A. Yes or no? Now, in this particular equation, if L is equal to 1 centimeter and area of cross section A is equal to 1 square centimeter. You can just see this figure, the adjoining figure here. So I am considering a conductor whereby the length of the conductor is 1 centimeter and area of cross section is 1 square centimeter. Then putting these values in this particular equation, what would be the final equation now you have? K is equal to C. So this is where your definition comes for specific conductivity. So you can say specific conductivity of a solution, or in terms of a conductor also you can define it. It is defined as the conductance of a solution of 1 centimeter length and having 1 square centimeter as an area of cross section. Is it okay? Now, if the volume of the solution, you are considering the solution whose conductance you need to find out. If the volume of the solution is V centimeter cube, okay, then what would be the specific conductivity of such a solution? At this dilution, you will be applying the same formula, but then you can represent that specific conductivity as KV or kappa V. Able to understand? So in terms of volume, you can write down as kappa V, which is the specific conductivity at a particular dilution V. Okay. Similarly, at a particular concentration C, the specific conductivity can be represented as kappa C. Okay. Now, after that, if you need to consider the various your units for this, how can you find out the units for this? Let me show you here. See, when I say resistivity, resistivity is rho is equal to R into A by L. Okay. Now, as far as resistance is concerned, it is given in terms of ohms, area of cross section, centimeter square, and length, centimeter. Okay. So, what would be the unit now? The unit is ohm centimeter. Okay. Similarly, in SI units, instead of ohm centimeter, I can write it down as ohm meter. Okay. So, that is the units for resistivity. The units for specific conductivity, it is reciprocal of this. So, the unit for specific conductivity will be reciprocal of this, right? So, that will be ohm inverse, centimeter inverse, right? Or you can say ohm inverse is equivalent to Siemens. So, it can be Siemens, centimeter inverse. Or again, in terms of SI units, I can say it is Siemens, meter inverse. Is it clear? That's the complete concept about specific conductivity. Now, next we'll move to what is equivalent conductivity. To understand the concept of equivalent conductivity, you need to consider one example. See, if you consider a student which is studying in standard 1, first class, and a student studying in standard 10, class 10, okay? Can you compare their IQ levels, their intellectual levels? Definitely not, right? That means for comparison, you need to set up certain criteria. And a similar way, you have to set up certain criteria for understanding the concept of equivalent conductivity. Because equivalent conductivity is a parameter which normally is used for comparisons of conductances. Okay? So for comparing the conductances of solutions of different electrolytes, it's essential that the first criteria is the volumes of the solutions should be same. Okay? And they must contain a definite amount of electrolytes. What do you mean by a definite amount of electrolyte? Such that that electrolyte should have tendency to produce ions which carry the same total charge. Okay. So, what is the best choice then? You have to consider the solutions which have equal volumes and containing their corresponding gram equivalent weights. How can you always measure the amount of the electrolyte giving the same amount of ion carrying charge? Okay. So, it's better to consider electrolytes in terms of their gram equivalent weights. Is it okay? And the conductance of such a solution when you get then, that is called as an equivalent conductivity, and it is denoted by lambda equivalent. Okay? So how can you define this equivalent conductivity? Equivalent conductivity of a solution at a dilution V is defined as the conductance of all the ions produced from 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte dissolved in V centimeter cube of the solution. Okay, so what is the basic concept you can understand in terms of your equivalent conductivity and specific conductivity? What was the concept there? What we said about specific conductivity earlier? Specific conductivity is the conductance of a solution which is defined for 1 centimeter cube of the solution. And what is equivalent conductivity? It is the conductance of a solution defined for 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte. Is it okay? So if you are able to understand both these concepts of specific as well as equivalent conductivity, we'll take certain cases to make it more clear to you. Let us consider the first case. Consider the first case. Suppose you are taking 1 centimeter cube of the solution containing 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte. Okay, then what will be the conductance of this solution? Can I say it is a specific conductivity? Yes, since there is 1 centimeter cube of the solution, that means I can say the conductance of the solution is directly giving you the value for the specific conductivity kappa, right? Further, in terms of equivalent conductivity, since I am saying this 1 centimeter cube of the solution also contains 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte, that means it is also giving you the value for equivalent conductivity. According to definition, that means you can say when 1 centimeter cube of the solution contains 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte, then equivalent conductivity is equal to the specific conductivity. Okay, now we will take the other case to it. Now take this particular case. So in this case, say 4 centimeter cube of the solution, okay, and is taken, and it contains 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte. Okay, so the conductance of such a solution which you will get, can I say it is equivalent to the equivalent conductivity? Yes, you will get the equivalent conductivity in this case when you measure the conductance of such a solution. What is the reason for this? Because it contains 1 gram equivalent of an electrolyte. Okay, but in this case, would you directly get the value for the specific conductivity of the solution as a whole? No. Why not? Because I'm talking here about 4 centimeter cube of the solution and not 1 centimeter cube of solution. That means, just imagine, you can divide this into 4 equal portions. Yes or no? 4 equal cubes. And each cube having a volume of 1 centimeter cube of the solution. That means each portion of that volume, right, will give you a specific conductivity. Yes or no? That means what I can say here, equivalent conductivity in this case is 4 times that of the specific conductivity. Yes or no? Right? So what are you having your final equation as? I can say the relation between equivalent and specific conductivity can be established as equivalent conductivity, lambda equivalent, is equal to specific conductivity in terms of dilution V multiplied by the volume. Is it okay? So this is an important relation between equivalent conductivity and the specific conductivity. Is it okay? Similarly, you can convert it in terms of normality, or you can even convert it in terms of molarity. So let us see that. As in this particular equation, we are taking V. What is V? V is the volume of solution in centimeter cube containing 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte. Okay? But if you want to convert the same equation in terms of concentration, then I can say if the solution has a concentration of C gram equivalents per liter. Okay, C gram equivalent per liter, that means I can say C gram equivalents are present in 1000 centimeter cube of the solution. Yes or no? That means the volume of the solution containing 1 gram equivalent will be how much? That will be 1000 divided by C. Yes or no? So let me fill this same value within this equation So I have equivalent conductivity, that is equal to, what would be your specific conductivity now, since in measuring in terms of concentration. So I'd be saying it is Kc multiplied by 1000 divided by C equivalent. Okay, so what you need to take care of this here is, in the first equation we are considering volume of the solution in centimeter cube containing 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte, and in the next solution, next equation here, we are taking concentration in gram equivalent per liter. Is it okay? After that, next we'll see what is molar conductivity. Molar conductivity of a solution is defined in a similar manner as that of equivalent conductivity. As far as this conductivity is concerned, it can be defined as the conductance of all the ions which is produced from 1 mole of the electrolyte dissolved in V centimeter cube of solution. Okay, and it is represented as lambda M. Okay, now as far as the relationship is concerned between molar conductivity and specific conductivity, it is set up as this way: lambda M is equal to KV into V. What was the relation between equivalent and specific conductivity? Similar way, instead of lambda M, you take here equivalent conductivity. Yes or no? Now, in terms of concentration, the equation which can be established for molar conductivity is given as this. So, your molar conductivity lambda M is equal to Kc into 1000 upon C. Since again we are taking concentration in terms of your moles per liter. Okay, so instead of normality, now I can convert the same equation in terms of molarity. So that will be Kc into 1000 upon molarity M. Is it clear? So let us revise it in the form of a conclusion, all types of conductivities now. So initially we understood what do you mean by resistivity, which was given by rho. Then we came to know what is kappa, which is known as a specific conductivity, right? And specific conductivity is specified particularly for 1 centimeter cube of the solution. Yes or no? Then we came to know what is the equivalent conductivity. And equivalent conductivity is given as lambda equivalent. And it is measured with reference to 1 gram equivalent of the electrolyte, right? Next, we considered the various cases for it. In one of the case, we established a relation for the equivalent conductivity and specific conductivity, that is Kc into 1000 divided by concentration, right? The same equation I can write it down as Kc into 1000 divided by normality N, since concentration here I am taking in terms of gram equivalent per liter, so that will be equivalent to the normality, right? Then the final thing, for molar conductivity we got an equation lambda M that is equal to Kc into 1000 upon C again, right, where concentration is represented in terms of moles of the electrolyte, right? Since it is represented in terms of moles of the electrolyte, so what I wrote down here, it is Kc into 1000 divided by molarity M. Okay, I hope all the concepts of this conductivities are clear to you. Okay, so that's for today. Thank you for watching.